Jim Carrey is one of Hollywood's most famous actors and one of the funniest men of all time, but in recent years, his life has completely changed. His face, always marked by goofy expressions, now has a somber look, and his words, once filled with jokes, now carry serious and profound messages, leading people to wonder what is happening with this man. Has he gone crazy? In today's video, we will find answers to these questions and understand the journey that led Jim Carrey to this point in his life, where he seems to have left behind the man who lived as a comedy movie character 24 hours a day to become who he was truly called to be in this world. What you will see in this video will surprise you, and at the end, I will show you a testimony from Jim Carrey himself that I am sure will impact your life. But before we start, I want to ask you to subscribe to my channel. It's very quick. Just click the subscribe button below the video, activate the notification bell, because I want to help you on your walk with God every day, okay? Now let's get started. Jim Carrey is a Canadian comedian who became famous worldwide for his roles in successful movies like The Truman Show, The Mask, Ace Ventura, Dumb and Dumber, among others. But it wasn't just in front of the cameras that the actor was always making jokes and entertaining everyone. In TV interviews, at award shows, or at major cinema events, he was always seen making jokes and acting like a true character, making everyone laugh. But why was Jim Carrey like that? Why was he always seen being funny all the time? Was it really a trait of his personality? Or was Jim Carrey trying to convey some message or even hide something from people? Well, to understand why Jim Carrey was funny all the time, we need to go back in time. Jim was born in a small town in Canada called Newmarket in January 1962. Being the youngest of a family of four siblings, son of a singer who did not achieve the success she hoped for, and a musician who had to give up his career on stage to support the family in a regular job, Jim grew up seeing his mother always sick. She became addicted to painkillers and developed a mental illness that made her believe she could die at any moment. And it was out of fear of losing his mother that little Jim Carrey started doing comedy to try to cheer her up a bit. The boy dedicated all his time to making his mother smile so that life would be a little easier for her. It was in this context that Jim Carrey's first comedy performances emerged. The actor grew up isolated and lonely, so creativity became his only friend. He painted, composed poetry, and made faces in front of the mirror. In an interview, he admitted that the mirror was his only friend and that he didn't know what socializing was. Sometime later, he realized that he could also make other people laugh, such as family acquaintances and school friends. Young Jim Carrey got so good at pleasing others with his performances, jokes, and faces that he was allowed by the school to give a 15-minute presentation every day in his classroom. At the same time, Jim's father lost his job, and they were evicted from their home, having to live in a van for a while until they found a new home in the United States. It was during this time that Jim Carrey realized he could use comedy to lift his family out of poverty. So he dedicated himself more and more to making people laugh. And it worked. After starting in the world of stand-up comedy, he went to the movies and became one of the biggest actors Hollywood has ever known. But besides the money, success, awards, and all the fame, Jim Carrey understood that to stay where he had reached, he needed to keep entertaining people all the time. And more than that, the comedy industry is entirely geared towards the opinions of others, and his work depended on people's positive judgment. That's why he became the man who was always making some kind of joke wherever he was. He became a reflection of what society wanted and expected him to be. Time passed until there came a moment when Jim Carrey began to fight an internal battle with himself. It was when he stopped being the clown everyone was used to seeing and underwent a profound change. He entered into depression, and this even influenced the projects he chose to do. The funny characters that made everyone laugh gave way to more serious ones, with deep stories that made the audience reflect on life. In the movie Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, Jim portrays a man frustrated with his love life and in depression, exactly how he was living at that moment. His performance during the filming was so good that the movie's director asked him not to treat his psychological problem until the end of the work. After that, Jim began to appear less and less in the media and decided to delve deeper into his search for his true identity. During this process, he also lost his ex-girlfriend, Kathriona White, who took her own life 5 days after ending the relationship with Jim. All of this made the actor even more desperate for answers about life. It was at this moment of deep pain that Jim Carrey found Jesus, the only truth capable of freeing human beings from the chains the world places on them and the slavery society imposes on us to be accepted. From then on, the man who dedicated his life to pleasing everyone now spoke to the world what he believed to be the truth. In an interview before an award show in the United States, this became very clear. Let's watch together.
Is it true you're wandering the streets? You need a date to the party? What's up?
No. I'm doing just fine. I wanted to find the most meaningless thing that I could come to and join, and here I am.
They say they're celebrating icons inside.
Celebrating icons. Boy, that is just the absolute lowest aiming, possibility that we could come up with.
You don't believe certain icons have the power to make change, to think differently, to be bold, to inspire others? Artistry, you're one of them.
On the good foot. Ha! Yeah. You shut it down now.
Notice the reporter's reaction as Jim Carrey talked about the futility of the entertainment world. She looks at the camera with a look of shock and disapproval, as if saying to the audience, "Look, folks, he's going crazy. I'm not like him. I'm not part of this madness. I'm like you." In addition, he decided to sacrifice his career in Hollywood to reveal the dark secrets of the entertainment industry, such as the influences of the Illuminati. In several public appearances, including the famous show Jimmy Kimmel Live, Jim Carrey made symbolic gestures and spoke openly about what he called the Illuminati's secret symbol. He assured that many in the entertainment industry were hired by the government to distract the public and manipulate them. He also had the courage to say that these decisions were made in secret meetings controlled by occult forces. Because of this type of attitude, many people began to create theories that Jim Carrey had indeed gone crazy and that there was something very wrong with the actor. But the great truth is that Jim Carrey felt something in his heart. He realized he needed to renounce the image and character he had carried to fulfill his true mission. So he began to free himself from all the labels that had accompanied him throughout his career. And more than that, Jim Carrey began to dedicate his life to social work, helping people in need, and learning about the Word of God. He is still in this process of spiritual growth and sanctification, and he has faced struggles that every newly converted Christian faces. After all, the enemy knows how precious this man's life is to God, and the impact this actor can have on the world if he decides to speak about Christ's love to others. I want to share with you a part of a testimony from Jim Carrey where he talks about his relationship with God. Check it out with me.
And ultimately, I believe that suffering leads to salvation. And in fact, it's the only way that we have to somehow accept, not deny, but feel our suffering and feel our losses, and then we make one of two decisions. We either decide to go through the gate of resentment, which leads to vengeance, which leads to self-harm, which leads to harm to others, or we go through the gate of forgiveness, which leads to grace. And your being here is an indication that you've made that decision already. You've made the decision to walk through the gate of forgiveness, to grace, just as Christ did on the cross. He suffered terribly, and he was broken by it to the point of doubt and a feeling of absolute abandonment, which all of you felt. And then there was a decision to be made. And the decision was to look upon the people who were causing that suffering, or the situation that was causing that suffering, with compassion and with forgiveness. And that's what opens the gates of heaven for all of us. So I wish that for all of you. I wish that for myself. I know that, no matter what I've suffered, most of you have suffered worse than that. But that's why I admire you, because you're here, you know? And you will have grace, because this decision has been made. So I'm so glad to be with you and to be a part of this. Thank you, Father Greg. Thank you, Jason.
Look at this, brothers. This testimony from Jim Carrey not only touches our hearts because of his life and the difficulties he faced, but also reminds us of that passage from the Bible in 1 Corinthians 1, verses 27 to 29, where the Apostle Paul says that God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise, and chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. Jim Carrey spent decades trying to please others to be accepted in an unfair and cruel world. And it may be that you who are listening to me now are going through the same situation. It may be that you are wearing a social mask just so that others do not reject you when, in fact, you are empty inside. Jim Carrey's life story is a call from God to you today. Abandon that character you have been playing and accept now the plan that God has for your life. Amen? I am sure that all the shadow that has pursued you until now will be dispelled by the light of the Holy Spirit. No matter how difficult your journey is at the beginning, because it will be Jesus Himself who will guide your steps. So repent of your sins, give your heart and your life and your future into the hands of the Lord, and He will take care of you. Amen? If this testimony of life and faith touched your heart, click the share button and send it to 3 people in your WhatsApp contacts. I am sure they will be very touched and blessed by this story. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. May God bless you powerfully. A big hug.